Hi dudes, how are you doing? You catch me on my holidays and I'm absolutely buzzing to tell you about this vehicle. This is the Volkswagen ID.Buzz and it comes in two stages, life and style. This is the life version. Let's go and take a little look and this is the life. Let's take a look at the front end of the Volkswagen ID.Buzz. And first of all, there's a lot of features I like, but the lights are one that jump out at me. How they curve around the front in towards the side of the car, and they're connected through this bar that goes all the way across. Now, it's not a light bar, but it is a bar. So you know how much I kind of like things like that. So it's way up in my like list. Biggest ever Volkswagen emblem on any vehicle. Look at that. It's almost the size of my hand. It's huge. And that's a throwback the original Volkswagen camper van from the 60s. Down the bottom, diamond-shaped vents for letting lots of air into the cooling. And it's just nice. It's short, it's stubby like a cold one, and we'll pick up on that later on inside. Let's take a look down the side of the Volkswagen ID.Buzz, and the first thing that jumps out at me is the 20-inch alloy wheels. You're going to love them. Stockton alloy wheels, they're called. There is an option for 19-inch alloy wheels, but I drove the vehicle here, and the road noise is minimal and the feel is great from the 20-inch alloy wheels. The door mirrors are huge and they let you see everything you need to out the side, and it looks pretty cool and trick with the indicator in the side of them as well when you need to use it. Making our way back down the side, very deep privacy glass, and it goes very well with the colour. Nice and groovy and trippy that. And in the detail that we have at the back, these three areas here are carried forward again like the logo in the front, from the original camper van. The air-cooled engine used to be in the back, and there used to be slots for the cooling, and that's just a little bit of a throwback towards its original camper van origin. The lights in the back are cool, and your charging flap is there. Ultimately, the side of the vehicle, spot on. Let's take a look at the back of the Volkswagen ID.Buzz, and some of the key features you're going to like. The roof spoiler, that's one of them. It drapes over the edges, nice and big, and it does look pretty sporty. And that window as well, the visibility you see out with that when you're inside is absolutely huge. Again, like the front, they've got the big logo on the back, and underneath the bumper at either side, you've got a couple of little diffuser areas, make it look nice and sporty. Inside the actual boot, you find 1,121 litres of boot space, which is huge. And you've got lovely little Volkswagen boxes here for your storage cables. But with 1,120 litres of storage space, we then put the seats flat and... So if you go for that ultimate road trip, it can take a 6'2" man lying fully stretched out in the back on a mattress, which it can blow up in the 12-volt socket just here. What more could you want? Our ID.Buzz comes in starlight blue metallic, but there is a whole selection of colours for you guys to choose from, including some groovy two-tones like this. We find ourselves inside the cockpit of the ID.Buzz, and you're going to notice straight away that comfort and storage are the key features in here. Comfortable seats, armrest for driver and passenger, and I've got the steering wheel exactly where I want it. There's a footrest down there on the left-hand side, which, as you know, I absolutely love. The dashboard's simple, and the infotainment system tells you exactly what you need to know. We're running Apple CarPlay, Android Auto is also there, but it's totally bulletproof. Then you get to storage. The doors themselves, there's double layers of storage, matted at the top, slightly smaller, and two big areas of storage across the front for me, and a big one for the passenger on the far side. Two USB chargers and a wireless charging mat there as well. Huge glove box and a double drinks holder here, and then the actual buzz box that's here, which is an optional extra, has storage in the back, top and in the front, and there's even an ice scraper here for the winter, should you need to scrape your windows. But above all else, it's a perfect place to be in. All we need to do is grab a nice cold beverage, your bottle opener, and away you go. The back of the vehicle is just as comfy and as spacious as the front of the vehicle. Legroom is fabulous, as is headroom. Remember, I'm 6'2", give or take a couple of inches, so there's not an issue for me being in the back here. And the storage is absolutely everywhere. The top of the seat has a little bag there, as it does at the bottom as well. And there's a lovely little working drinks table, which folds out from the back of the seat. You can get your drinks cup in there. The door itself, double storage, top and bottom. The top storage also has a USB charger in it, either side for your passengers. Isofix is nice and easy to get to, and the seats are really, really comfortable in the back. I do like it. Overall, the ID.Buzz is a winner. But now, let's get on the road. Let's get on with the serious business and drive this car. My first impressions of the Volkswagen ID.Buzz is fun, fun, fun. There we go. Great thing to drive. It doesn't feel huge. You're quite high up. The visibility is amazing. And it drives along the road lovely. It's no problem at all. We've been cruising at motorway speed, 70 miles per hour, very low wind noise, no road noise whatsoever. Yeah, I do like it. It's proper, proper 60s vibes in this. I like it. Groovy. You have 204 brake horsepower, which drives off the rear wheel drive motor. You have a 77 kilowatt battery in this vehicle. 258 miles is your real world range, and it will charge from 5% to 80% in 30 minutes on a 170 kilowatt DC charger. It doesn't charge on 22 kilowatt AC chargers, but not many vehicles do. But it's still a good range and a quick charger. Two models of ID.Buzz. There's life and there's style, as there would be. The life that we're in, £59,000. The style starts around £64,000. But this one, the life with all our extras, comes in at just over £62,000. And we'll cover the extras in a couple of minutes because there's so many. Optional extras: heated leatherette wrapped multifunctioning steering wheel, heated seats, heated windscreen, heated washer nozzles as well, so they won't freeze up in the winter. You've also got an auto-dimming rearview mirror, and an optional extra is the buzz box in the middle. There's so many things for you to choose from. You can spec your own ID.Buzz just how you want it. Through the town as well, it's great. It's a really nice town driver as we come through here. We're in the middle of a busy area just now, and lots of roundabouts. And because you're that little bit higher up, it gives you great visibility over the roundabout. Inside the ID.Buzz, the sound system, absolutely brilliant, as you would imagine. 9 speakers in total around the inside of this, and if you go into the infotainment system, you can actually move the sound about. So if you want all the sound at the back, you can have all the sound at the back. If you want it at the front, likewise. But a really good sound system, crystal clear, perfect. Just what the Summer of Love wanted. It's a beautiful day, and we're heading to the Isle of Bute. We've got the Apple CarPlay connected, which is wireless. It's also available for Android Auto, and it's really easy to connect to the infotainment system through the wireless play. There's a couple of USB chargers here should you need to plug yourself in. And we're heading for a beautiful ferry trip to the Isle of Bute in our ID.Buzz, where we're going to have some, shall we say, fun on the ferry and fun on the island. Well, here we go. We're making the journey onto the ferry. This one's called Argyle, and we are the very last vehicle making it on, because the ID.Buzz has got a special place at the back. So let the fun and games begin as we head on to our Calmac ferry. Isle of Bute, here we come. Here we go, a lovely 35 minute ferry trip over to the Isle of Bute. And here we are, lovely sunny day, and let the adventure begin in the buzz. I hear bagpipes. I hear bagpipes. I wonder if they pipe everybody off the ferry. What a nice thought. Now, the ID.Buzz is no rocket ship, okay? It's not to infinity and beyond, let me tell you that. 0 to 62, 10.2 seconds. It's got 204 brake horsepower, and it goes to 40 miles per hour really quickly. And it just tails off a little bit after that, but it will get you there in just over 10 seconds. Right then, launch time. We're out of traffic lights. Obviously, we're going to do this within speed limit, and we're in a 40 mile an hour speed limit just now. So let's see what this launches away from the traffic lights up to 40 like. It should get there pretty quickly, and then it'll probably tail off a little bit after that, but we'll slow down at 40 because we like to play within the rules of the law. This could be the longest awkward pause at a traffic light ever, as we've got four-way traffic lights and everything else now seems to be changing rather than us. Just talk amongst yourself. Three, two, one, go. Ooh, oh, she gets there quite quickly actually. Your driving modes in the ID.Buzz come at eco, comfort and sport, as in most cars. And there's also an individual one. So you can cherry pick your favourite ones from each of those three previous modes and set up your own tailor-made profile. Right now we're cruising along at 2.8 miles per kilowatt hour. If you times that by the size of the battery, which is 77 kilowatts in this, that gives us a real world range of 215 miles. Now, yes, it's meant to be 258, but for what we've been doing today, we've been on the Isle of Bute, we've been up and down country lanes, very hilly, very uneconomical style of driving, yet it's still giving us a really, really good return. And with a little bit more care and attention from the driver, that could probably come up. From my first impression to where we're sitting just now, I like the buzz initially, but I really like it now. It does everything I want it to do. It's comfortable, it's quite nippy, it's quite pokey, but ultimately the mileage is fabulous for it. We have got 69% battery left. We've got 160 miles left. I've been driving it all day. Am I in love with the ID.Buzz? Well, it's gone from the like list to the love list, so it's moving up steadily. Well, that's my thought on the ID.Buzz. I absolutely love it. It's nothing but fun, smiles, and nice and comfortable for that longer journey. But I need to know if you agree with me. Drop a comment in the box below and let me know what you think if you've driven one. If you haven't driven one, get yourself to an Arnold Clark Volkswagen garage and see if you can get behind the wheel of the ID.Buzz. Until next time, I've been Duncan Vincent. This has been the Arnold Clark YouTube channel. Make sure you like and subscribe and hit that bell icon so you never miss a notification from us. Until next time, safe driving.